Topic for this morning, spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. Topic one more time, spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. Post my humble self like a king. Text taken in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 2, from verse 19 to 22. But let's pray before we begin. Father, thank you for the breath in our nostrils. We've come to hear from you this morning. Father, we ask, speak to us and grant us understanding. Let the light of your word shatter every darkness in our lives according to Isaiah chapter 60, from verse 1 down to 3. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Topic one more time. Spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. Post look at key text taken book of 2 Timothy chapter 2 from verse 19 to 20. Sorry, from verse 19. Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal. The Lord knoweth them that are his, and let everyone that name the name of Christ depart from iniquity. Verse 20 said, but the great house, they are not only vessels of gold and of silver, but also of wood and some, but also of wood and of earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. Verse 21 said, if a man therefore purge himself from this, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified and made for the master's use, and prepared unto every good work. May the Lord bless his work and his understanding. In Jesus' name, for I read Isaiah 58 from verse 6 down to 14. He said, is not this the fast that I have chosen? He said, it's not just the fast that I have chosen, to lose the bands of wickedness, to undo the heavy burdens, and to let your praise go free, and that ye break every yoke, except by 7. Is it not to do that bread to the hungry, and that thou bring the poor that are cast out of thy house, and thou seest the naked, and thou shalt cover him? Verse 8 said, then shall the light break forth as the morning, and thy health shall spring forth speedily, and thy righteousness shall go before thee. The glory of the Lord shall be thy real reward. I take verse 8 again for emphasis. Said, then shall the light break forth as the morning, and thy health spring forth speedily, and thy righteousness shall go before thee. After righteousness, then what? The glory of the Lord shall be your reward. All through this season and beyond, I see God's glory being your reward in Jesus. When for that said, then thou shalt call the Lord. When I say verse 9, verse 10 said, then I will guide thee continually and satisfy thy soul. He drought and make thy bones fat, and thou shalt be like a watered garden, and like a spring of water, which water filleth not. And complete that scripture down to verse 14. Joel chapter 2, from verse 1 down to 27. I'll skip some verses. He said, blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is near at hand. He said, a fire invested before, right before them, talking about this group of people. A fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burning. The land is as the garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness, yea, and nothing shall escape them. Said in verse 4, the appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen that shall they run, so shall they run. Said in verse 7, they shall run like mighty men, they shall climb the wall like men of war, and they shall march everyone through, and they shall not break their ranks. Said in verse 8, neither shall one trust another, they shall walk everyone in his path. Said, and when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded. What a people. Said in verse 9, they shall run to and fro in the city, they shall run upon the wall, they shall climb up upon the houses, and they shall enter in at the windows like thieves. Said in verse 10, the earth shall quake before them. I see you being part of this group of folks they're talking about here in the name of Jesus. Said in verse 10, the earth shall quake for them, the heavens shall tremble, the sun and the moon shall break dark, and the stars shall retell their shining. Said verse 12. Therefore also now, said the Lord, turn ye even to me. Look at the condition. How can you be a part of this army? He said, therefore also in verse 12, saith the Lord, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fasting, and with weeping, and with mourning. Said in verse 13, and rend your heart, and not your garment, and turn unto the Lord your God. For he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and great of kindness, and repented him of the evil. Said in verse 15, blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly. Say, gather the people, sanctify the congregation. In verse 16, assemble the elders, gather the children, and those that serve the breast. Let the bridegroom go forth of his chamber, and bride out of her closet. Said in verse 24, and the floor shall be full of wheat, and vat shall overflow with wine and oil. Said in verse 25, and I will restore to you the year that the locusts have eaten, the cacao, the caterpillar, the palm of the great ambush which I have sent among you. You shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. and praise the name of the Lord, and the people shall never be ashamed, and you will know that I'm in the midst of thee. Complete that scripture down to verse 27. Topic one more time, spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. Host my humble self, okay, text the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2, from verse 19 to 22. We'll read that further again. Isaiah chapter 58, from verse 6 to 14, and Joel chapter 2, 1 to 27. Please, I want to beg you to let your time. Read these scriptures again. You'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Thinking cap, a mind-blowing word for this morning is, every spiritual blessing will eventually transcend to physical blessings. Take it again. Every spiritual blessings will eventually transcend to physical blessings. Think about this. Today we'll look at the topic, spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers. We shall double up our teaching series for the week. So please, I implore you to stay connected with us on this platform or through this week. You'll be blessed in Jesus' name. By introduction, let's know that until we are blessed spiritually, we can't be blessed physically. Many people seek for physical blessings at all costs, but little do they know that spiritual blessings naturally attract physical blessings without measures. Meaning, let's learn to settle down with God in seeking spiritual things, spiritual blessings, and not chasing men for bread and wine. Remember, life is highly spiritual, and the spiritual rules the physical. On this note, we shall learn about spiritual blessings and how we can position ourselves to tap into the spiritual blessings. And I pray even today, God will bless you in Jesus' name. Genesis 32 from verse 22 to 28, we see the man called Jacob. He settled with God. He never ran after people to go solicit and beg his brother Esau, but he died with God seeking for divine blessings. And when the blessings came, Esau had no children to forgive Jacob to move on with their lives. He said in verse 22, and he arose that night and took his wives and his two men servants and his 11 sons and passed over the ford Jabbok. And verse 23, and he took them and sent them over to the brook and sent over that he had. And in verse 24, and Jacob was left alone. He separated himself. He pulled out himself from the crowd, and yet he wrestled man with him until the breaking of the day. You know yourself. You know the challenges that are ahead of you. You know the causes from others out there trying to chase you to your own house. So you have to combat them spiritually to come out of it. I pray the grace to identify what the challenge is and know how to tackle it will be a portion this morning in Jesus. 24, and Jacob was left alone, and they wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. And when a man saw that he prevailed against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of time. He said, as he wrestled with him, and verse 26, and he said, let me go today. He said, I'm going to let you accept that word that blessed me. Jacob never went looking for kings to go and beg his brother. He came to God. And verse 27, and he said, what is your name? I said, his name is Jacob. He said, thy name shall not be called Jacob or Israel, for thou hast power with God and with men, and hast prevailed. God will change your name in Jesus' name. Second Chronicles 2, verse 1 down to 26, look at another group of people who never ran to other armies to come and ally with them to battle these people who have come to battle with them, but they settled down with God, seeking the face of God for victory. And God talking about Judah and Joshua. Second Chronicles 20, from verse 1 down to 26. And it came to pass after this also that children of Moab, children of Ammon, and on the other side, the Ammonites, came against Joshua to battle three mighty nations. He said in verse 2, then there came some and told Joshua, saying, they are committing great multitude against him from beyond the sea on the side of Syria, and behold, they be in Azatotan, which is in Ilgali. And verse 20 and verse 3, and Joshua feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaim a fast throughout all Judah. The grace for you to give all it takes in fasting and prayers to come out of those addictions, to come out of the challenge of your life, will be a portion in Jesus' name. Verse 4 said, and Judah gathered themselves together to seek help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. And verse 13, and all Judah stood before the Lord with their little ones, their wives, and their children. And he said, hearken ye, in verse 15, he said, ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Joshua, thus says the Lord, do not be afraid nor dismay by reason of this great multitude, for that battle is not yours, but God. So this is a spiritual battle, and I pray heaven will grant us victory. Jesus, verse 16 said, tomorrow go down against them, for they come to the cliff of Zin. He shall find them by the end of the book. Imagine you want to go fight and know where the enemy is coming from. You just lay ambush and clear them. However, God said, you don't need to fight. Then, verse 17, ye shall not need to fight this battle. Set yourself. I mean, package yourself. Set yourself. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord with you. Oh, Judea and Jerusalem. Fear not. Not be dismayed. Tomorrow, go against them. For the Lord will be with you. And of course, we saw them. They said, and said, began to praise and to worship the Lord. The Lord said, ambushment against you, no more. I'm up. And everyone destroyed the other. Look at the verse 2. So when they began to pray, the Lord said, you set yourself with God, you set ambushment against your enemies. So the Lord set ambushment against the children of Ammon, which were come against Judah, and they were smitten. For the children of Ammon stood up against the inhabitants of Mount Seir, utterly sent to destroy them. And when they had made an end of the inhabitants of Seir, everyone had to destroy another. When Judah was come to us, they saw dead bodies from the skin. It took them 3 days to gather the spoils. So from that war, they became very, very wealthy because they got out the riches that came from dead bodies. And they were blessed. I pray, as you seek the face of the Lord, go grab spiritual victory. And if you have fears of your life in Jesus' name, Luke chapter 2 from the start, 6 down to 28. And there was one Anna, a prophetess, the daughter of Phanuel, said of a tribe of Asher, she was of a great age and had lived her husband 7 years after her virginity. Then it was 37. And she was a widow of fourscore and 4 years. She departed not from the temple, but served God with fastings and prayers night and day. And look at it. And she coming, was 38. She never died. She was alive until she saw the glory of the Lord. She saw Christ. And she coming in instantly, like what? Was the Lord spoke of him to all them that look for redemption in Jerusalem. She says she's not going to die until she see the Son of God. She see the Son of God. She saw Christ. And of course, she saw him. And I pray, as you seek the glory of the Lord, you see his glory as you wait upon him. In truth, in Jesus' name. Speaking of our topic, what are the real spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers? Real spiritual blessings of fasting and prayer. We're looking at one point today. We're looking at the blessing of quality of righteousness. We're looking at what? The blessing of quality righteousness. One more time. What are the real spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers? And we're looking at the blessing of quality righteousness. This simply is living the heaven's order of righteousness and light on the earth, irrespective of the gloomy appearance of darkness on the earth. I declare again, subtopic. We're looking at real spiritual blessings of fasting and prayers, and we're dealing with the blessings of quality righteousness. Blessings of what? Quality righteousness. Therefore, that's it. This simply is living the heaven's order of righteousness and light on the earth, irrespective of the gloomy appearance of deep darkness of the earth. In Genesis chapter 39, from verse 1 down to 23, and Joseph was brought down to Egypt, and Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh, captain of the guard, an Egyptian, brought him at the hands of Ishmaelite, which had brought him down to Egypt. And in verse 2, and the Lord was with Joseph. Look at the testimony. The Lord was with Joseph. The Lord cannot be with you if you are righteous. The Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man. And was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And his master saw that the Lord was with him, and that the Lord made, and that he made him to prosper in his hand, set him for. And Joseph found grace in his sight, and he served him, and he made him oversee over all his house. The man doesn't even know what is what. And he said, look at the issue. And it came to pass after these things that his master's wife cast eyes upon Joseph, and she said, lie with me. And he was 8, and he refused and said unto his master's wife, behold, my master, who likes not what is with me in the house, and he hath committed all that he had to my hands. Said in verse 9, there is none greater in this house than I, neither hath he kept anything from me but thee, because thou art his wife. How can I do this great wickedness and sin against the Lord? That is a righteous man, a man with quality righteousness before God. Of course, if he had slept with her, no one would have known. But he knew that God was watching. And verse 10 came to pass as she spoke to him daily, that I cannot unto her. She framed him up, and at the end of the day, he went to prison. Then they came out, even while in the prison, the Lord was still with him. And he came out with victory. You can copy that. Verse 23, Ecclesiastes chapter 8, verse 13. He said, and it shall not be well with the wicked, neither shall he prolong his days, which are as a shadow, because he feared none before the Lord. So each time we sin against God, we have become wicked. And look at what Ecclesiastes said, it shall not be well with the wicked. So if you want to do well with you, then maintain a quality righteousness with God. God will grant you understanding of Jesus. And Joseph maintained a quality righteousness with God, and he ended up second in command in the land of captivity. He was made a lord even unto Pharaoh. No man could take a decision in Egypt except through Joseph. He was teaching the senators wisdom because he maintained a quality of righteousness with God. Psalm chapter 1, verse 1, he said, blessed is the man that walketh in the counsel of the godly, nor stand in the way of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scornful. He said, but his delight in the law of the Lord, and the Lord of the Lord did day and night. In verse 2, verse 3, he said, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, bringing forth his fruit in the season. His leaf also shall be withered, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. That will be a new rain in Jesus' name. But if they are godly and also they are like chaff, which the wind driveth away. That will not be you, Jesus' name. Isaiah 61:3. He said, arise, shine, for the light is come, and the glory of the Lord is upon thee. He said, behold, in verse 2, that darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people, for the Lord shall rise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. God's glory will be revealed even in this season of sin, even in this earth filled with sin and idolatry. God's glory will reveal upon you. God's righteousness will reveal upon you in Jesus' name. Verse 3 said, and Gentiles shall come to thy light, and kings to the brightness of their eyes. You'll be different among men in Jesus' name. John chapter 14, verse 30 said, hereafter I will not talk much with you. The prince of this world cometh and hath nothing in me. I pray, when they weigh you side by side, you'll not be found wanting in the name of Jesus. When heaven weigh you, you'll not be found wanting. When men weigh you, you'll not be found wanting in Jesus. The righteousness of God will be whose land and will be speaking in your life and your generation in Jesus. In 2 Timothy 2, 19, 22, and God's scripture said, nevertheless, the foundation of God's and they shall have it. They see the Lord, know them by ease. And let every one of them in the name of Christ depart from iniquity, depart from what? Iniquity, that let him maintain a quality righteousness with God. Said in verse 20, but in a great house, there are not only vessels of gold and of silver, and also of wood and of earth, and some to honor, and some to dishonor. That if any man therefore purge himself from this, in verse 21, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified, and meet the master, and prepare unto every good work that will be you in Jesus' name. You don't know what I'm trying to say, but looking at a subtopic, what it reveals, spiritual blessings of personal prayers, and looking at the blessings of quality of righteousness. When Father said, this simply is living the heaven's order of righteousness and light on this earth, irrespective of the appearance of darkness on this earth. Genesis chapter 39, from 1, we see Joseph maintain quality righteousness walk with God. Also, Ecclesiastes 8 to 13, cautioning us that it shall not be well with the wicked. So, when we sin against God, we become wicked, and it shall not be well with us, but that will not be our portion of Jesus. Psalm 1, 1 to 3 shall be our portion of Jesus. And Isaiah 60, 1 to 3 also shall be ours. John 14:30, the prince of this world, talking about the devil, came to Christ and found nothing. Jesus was perfect. Everyone will be perfect as Jesus was, in Jesus' name. 2 Timothy 2:19-22, so we have to choose our class. If we want to be a vessel of gold, or of silver, or of earth, or of wood, and of course, some to honor, and some to dishonor. We all know that gold is being honored by everyone. That will be our new realm in Jesus' name. Lastly, let's recognize that without spiritual blessings on our lives, we'll just be barren of glory and testimonies. I'll take that again. Let's recognize that without spiritual blessings in our lives, we'll just be barren of glory and testimonies. Men of renown were men of quality righteousness. Remember, that righteousness is right walk with God. So without a quality righteousness, there can't be a quality walk with God. And for sure, without a quality walk with God, there can't be a blessing of God in our life. Meaning, we have to accept Jesus in truth and the Spirit so we can receive a new level of quality work with God, which is transcend into quality righteousness and of course quality spiritual blessings. And that will be our portion in Jesus. In Daniel chapter 1, verse 1 down to 21, another man that maintained a quality work, we're talking about Daniel, they were taken captives into Babylon. And of course, they chose them to teach them the language of the challenge, and they were to feed them with the king's portion. But he said, I will not define myself with the king's portion himself. Talking about Michel, Azara, Daniel, and Anani. These are children from Judah. Said in verse 8, but Daniel proposed in his heart that he will not defile himself with a portion of the king's meat, with the wine which he drank. before he requested the prince of Edom that they should feed them with only water and vegetable, and that was all that they were eating, these four children. And in verse 13, and as for these four children, God gave them knowledge, skill in all learning and wisdom. And Daniel had understanding all visions and dreams. And of course, we all know, afterward, Nebuchadnezzar brought them forward and commune with them in verse 19. And the king Nebuchadnezzar commune with them, and among them all was found none like Daniel, and Mishael, and Azariah. Therefore, stood they before the king, and verse 20, and in all matters of wisdom and understanding, and the king acquired of them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and astrologers there were in Israel. And then he continued even unto the first year of King Cyrus. He was reigning, of course, at the top command. Be your new one. As you walk quality, as you walk with great quality of righteousness before God, God will set you on high in Jesus' name. Jeremiah chapter 3, 14, 22 said, behold, the days come to the Lord that I will perform the good things which I have promised unto the house of Israel. Unto the house of Judah, what is that good thing? In those days, at that time, will I cause the plant of righteousness to grow up unto David, and he shall execute judgment and righteousness. And that will be your portion of opportunity. In those days, shall Judah be saved, and Jerusalem shall dwell safely. And this is the name wherewith she shall be called, the Lord our righteousness. And verse 17, but thou says the Lord, David shall never want a man to sit upon the throne of his house. That will be you, you will sit on top of the top. In Jesus' name. Complete that scripture down to verse 22, Psalm chapter 1, verse 1 and 3. Brother Eliel, I'm talking about, blessed is the man that walketh on the counsel of God, nor sit in the seat of discomfort, nor stand in the way of sin, and said, but his delight in the law of the Lord. Said, in the Lord does he meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by rivers of water that bring forth his fruit. That will be a portion in Jesus' name. Psalm 1:4 said, righteousness of the testimony is everlasting. Give me understanding of it, and I shall live, said the righteousness of the testimony is everlasting. Give me understanding, and I shall live. Oh, grant you the understanding of righteousness, of righteousness, and the grace to live in that realm. In Jesus, in Hebrews chapter 2, 1 and 3 said, therefore, we ought to give a most earnest heed to the things which have risen, and any time we shall not escape. He said, in verse 3, how shall we escape from the grace of salvation, which at first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed to us by them that had him. And of course, Hebrews 11, 4 to 6. And you can read that, that he always said by faith, Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, by which he obtained witness that he was righteous. God will give a testimony concerning that you're righteous in Jesus' name. I want to pray with you. You want to say yes to Jesus. You want to refrain from the devil to follow Christ. You want a new heart to walk in quality righteousness with God. I pray with you, place your hand on your chest, bow your head, and say, Jesus, I come to you this morning. I know I'm a sinner, forgive for my sins, and I come to the same for my sake. Today was my freedom. Right now, I confess in Jesus, my Lord, and my Savior, have mercy upon me. Wash me with the blood and purify me. Write my name in the book of life. Grant me grace to live a quality righteous life with you all the days of my life, and set me on the top, in Jesus' name. Amen. We take two prayers. First prayer, Father, all through my fasting period, grant me the blessings of quality righteousness in my work with you. In Jesus' name. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 5 said, by faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death and was not found because God had translated him. But before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God. He had this testimony that he pleased God. That would be your testimony. In Jesus' name, Father, all through my fasting period, grant me the blessings of quality righteousness and work with you. In Jesus' name, thank you for hearing me. In Jesus' name. Last prayer, Father, among the saints in Africa, raise true branches of righteousness. In Jesus' name, Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 5 said, behold, the day is come, said the Lord, that I will raise unto David a righteous branch, and a king shall reign and prosper, and shall execute judgment and justice in the earth. Would you understand? Let's say, Father, among the saints in Nigeria and Africa, raise true branches of righteousness in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, among the saints in Nigeria and Africa, raise true branches of righteousness in Jesus' name. Join me for this prayer, share this gospel, and bless from the intercession ministry. God blesses you tomorrow. I pray that this day will be a day of God's favor. Someone is going to call you, going to send you favor in the name of Jesus. God bless you. See you tomorrow. In Jesus' name.